Harari says the countries and companies that control the most data will in the future be the ones that control the world.
Today in the world, data is worth much more than money. 10 years ago, you had these big corporations paying billions and billions for WhatsApp, for Instagram, and people wondered, are they crazy? Why do they pay billions to get this application that doesn't produce any money? And the reason why? Because it produced data.
And data is the key.
The world is increasingly kind of cut up into spheres of data collection, or data harvesting. In the Cold War, you had the Iron Curtain. Now you have the Silicon Curtain between the USA and China. And where does the data go? California, or does it go to Shenzhen and to Shanghai and to Beijing?
This is where they start.
Where the actors are completely inaudible, or something like this.
Hi, Phil Swift here for Flex Tape, the super strong waterproof tape that can instantly patch bonds. We're strong, and once it's on, it holds on tight.
And for emergency auto repair, keeps its grip, even in the toughest conditions.
Yeah, today I think the inequality in AI is quite a serious matter and people have to work on it. Fortunately, I think we can make a big improvement in the short term. We've probably read about a large American company trained its HR AI using a lot more men than women, and it ended up being very biased against letting women pass the screen. And that kind of error in the imbalance of data that you expose to an AI system, so much of one gender or race or whatever, and so little of others, will cause AI systems to be biased. And those can be caught by automatic tools that will alert the AI programmer of saying, you should not launch this because it will have this kind of an impact. So I think we can catch 80-90% of the most obvious of the problems, because they're pretty obvious mistakes. We should also train AI engineers to be conscientious that they're not just trying to build a tool, make money, but rather they're going to impact people's lives. So I think we can keep that under control. But there are a lot of subtleties that are very hard. If we do a really good job on the big mistakes, I think we will reach a point that AI will be already less biased than people. We don't recognize how biased we are. Think about a loan officer at the bank. If you ask them, well, why did you turn down that person's loan? You know, they'll usually give you a legitimate reason: insufficient income, too new at the job, or something. But buried in that person's subconsciousness is a lot of bias and prejudice. Things like the person doesn't look trustworthy, or I don't trust, you know, men or women or whatever. That kind of thing does come through, and AI will. We can do such a good job by honing the right data set, eliminating biases in the data as much as we can, so that AI can and will do better than people. Another example with people is there's a study in Israel that showed that judges gave harsher sentences just before lunch, just because they were hungry. So it's not even caused by prejudice. They're just, I'm hungry, I'm going to be mean. So I think AI can and will do better. And this doesn't mean we shouldn't work on it. We should work very hard on it to make AI as fair and biased as possible. But we should not look at it and say, well, it's so much worse than people, because we're all people. We can think about, are we really unbiased? I think we actually are quite poor, and AI should be a blessing if we do a good job.